Thank you for this honor. I'd like to thank the Athletic Advisory Board, President John Leahy, Athletic Director Jack McDonald, my coach Jim Armstrong, as well as our current coach, Rand Pecknold, for my induction into Quinnipiac's Hall of Fame. Congratulations to all my fellow inductees and their families as well. When I told my 7-year-old son, Andrew, I was being inducted into the Hall of Fame, he had a puzzled look on his face and said, "Dad, you never scored any goals at Quinnipiac." He was referring to the alumni games he has been to, where I have been experiencing a little drought. I have many fond memories of Quinnipiac hockey and consider myself very fortunate to have reaped the benefit of having many of my former coaches and teammates as friends today. There's a camaraderie that exists that will last a lifetime, and I have Quinnipiac hockey to thank for this. I think it is important to acknowledge how far our program has come. December 1975, under Coach Jim Kennedy, Quinnipiac knocked off Central Connecticut State University 7-5 for its first ever varsity men's hockey victory. March 1987, under Coach Armstrong, with assisting coaching from Hall of Famers Michael Barrett and Billy Venaris, we advanced to the ECAC tournament finals for the first time in school history. We won't go over the results of that game. It leads us to today under the leadership of Rand Pecknold, where Quinnipiac is a threat to knock off anyone on their schedule. Congrats on your victory last night against the Buckeyes and taking them again tonight, Coach. I think he's on the other side practicing right now. My teammates and I have always said we laid the foundation for the program that exists today. If it were not for my teammates, I would not be standing here today for this honor. I'd like to thank Sween, Mizika, Ricky, Mac, Tano, Guido, Baldy, Cap, Cusano, Angel, Salado, Heinze, Barrett, Bobby, Jensen, Pendy, Todd, Andy, Gardner, Rondo, Barth, Pat, Conti, Erse, Payne, Lebroni, AJ, Darren, Rice, Lyons, and Cook. Can't forget Cook. In addition to thanking my teammates, I need to recognize an individual whose dedication and commitment to getting his son and I to every practice. Sonny Payne, Louie Payne's dad, would drive me and Louie to every practice. We had practice at 10 o'clock at night at the Hampton Rink, and I know Sonny has made more of those practices than I did. Coach Armstrong can attest to that, so thank you, Mr. Payne. That brings me to my mother and father and their unwavering commitment to me and my 6 siblings. I have been incredibly blessed with a loving and supportive family, how my parents were able to put 7 children through college still baffles me today. Being a hockey parent is no small feat. All those 5:30 a.m. practices at Ingalls Rink, Paul Farron, and the fact that my dad never missed a prep school game at Loomis is worthy of Hall of Fame status. Thank my brother Bob for joining us today, and my brother John, who was my teammate on many youth hockey teams, could not be here. He's coaching 2 of his 4 youth hockey playing children in a tournament in Virginia. And lastly, I'd like to recognize